podcast to go.
All right. Welcome back, everyone. This is game three between pain and skill difference. This is the finals of the Prodota qualifier, North American qualifier, and this is what it all comes down to. So game one was taken by the Brazilians convincingly. Game two was just stolen horribly by the Americans. And for those of you just tuning in, we are going to play the national anthem of the winning teams. The winning team's national anthem at the end of the match. So stay tuned for that. It's going to be pretty epic. Never before seen. Yeah.
Holy, you can turn your mic off, by the way. Oh, are you? Okay, go.
Why would Holy think he's casting with me?
No. The better question is, why would I say anything if Holy would have cast it with you instead of me?
I would have probably just left.
I would have screwed myself. Damn it. That would have been so entertaining.
We should let Holy cast sometime.
We should. I feel kind of, back when I used to watch you and Cap and Insane Rabbi and everything back in Han, and I always remember seeing Holy like posting every video, but I never saw him actually in any video. And I was wondering what does this guy do exactly? Like, why is he making all these videos but not actually casting any? What is it for? Yeah, now I know. Now I know Holy, so it all makes sense to me. But I could never fathom it at the time. So I think he needs his moment in the spotlight. I've heard him. I mean, if you've heard his motivational speeches, obviously you know that
I've been subject to several of those motivational speeches.
I don't mean if. I mean, because I know you've been there with me for him. I'm just saying, as for a person in general, if someone has heard his motivational speeches, they understand that he can.
Oh, he can motivate people for sure. Oh yeah, he is inspirational. If you can imagine that, yeah. Holy, you make my world go round. I heard an unmute. Radiant. I heard a big fat unmute from Holy. Like he wanted to say something. Can people hear you or not? Okay. Good. Nobody else should have to be subject to you. Just us. Hey, these bands, Hari, do your damn job.
Son of a bitch. Come on. I just want to finish my food in peace.
All right.
I'm so starving. All right. Yeah, so these bands are basically all the imbalanced heroes, minus Darkseer and Tide, maybe Leshrac, and yeah.
Okay, you know what? Like, you don't even have to. Like, you don't have to say anything. Like, I just get so annoyed that there's this expectation to talk about the first six bands, or it used to be the first four bands. It's like, people, you know how this works. There's really not much to say. I mean, look at it. And we've got some reactionary bands. Like, no one ever bans Nightstalker anymore. Yeah. People should be able to know that, though. But I guess that's just me being lazy, to be fair.
So, you're eating, will it be Tide or will it be Windrunner?
Or Lesh.
Or Lesh. Yeah. I'm still feeling Tide. Tide. Oh, yeah. Tide Lesh or Lesh Tide?
I think it's going to be Tide Lesh.
Okay, well, whatever. I mean, it's Brazil. Yeah, it could be, but I think it's going to be Windrunner Tide here, or Tide Windrunner. Oh, wait, no, Windrunner's banned. Oh, so it's Tide Lesh. Yeah, Tide Lesh.
I am clairvoyant if this is Lesh. Because I got Darkseer last time, remember?
Okay, yeah, but the Darkseer one, I will admit, was a nice call on your part. The Tide Lesh, give me a break. That would be like if Windrunner was still there and I said Tide Windrunner, it's... Come on, that's nothing. It's not impressive. That's just taking the most imbalanced heroes you can and going with it. But they might not take Lesh here, which is why they're thinking. I think that's probably what they're thinking about. They're like, we could take Lesh. Lesh is really strong, but...
Yeah. Oh! Sign me up! Call me Cleo. My name is Cleo. Cleo the fortune teller.
So, yeah, first pick Crystal Maiden. I guess what happened here is in the first game, they had their
VS. VS.
Yep.
VS. Oh, you know what? I don't know if they're gonna VS now. Sorry, because they don't have their null Nightstalker combo, so it's not a null. I'm not gonna call this one.
Well, anyway, so in the first game they had their nice little CM VS roaming, but then in the second game actually the Americans, the evil American Empire, picked up the CM, preventing them from getting it. So they had to go with some Pugna, and instead of doing their nice little dual roaming strategy, they had to do some normal nonsense. So that's why they prioritized that CM pick right away this time.
First pick, CM. That is some next-level metagame brought to you by Brazil.
Yeah, that is definitely about as next level metagame as it gets.
Yeah. Although, I always bring this up. This is a lot like Han, you know, a lot of the same picking strategies in Han that these guys are employing right now. Han, you'd always take your support heroes first, always, and it would always be like your. It would be all incarnations of support. It wouldn't just be hard support. Beastmaster, maybe they fear the smokes. Taking a page out of Mao's book.
Yeah, but it wasn't really skill difference that was doing the smokes. It was more pain was doing more smokes, wasn't it? So I don't know. Maybe they're afraid of their own smokes.
Maybe they're just afraid of smokes in general. Maybe they have lung cancer.
Yeah. Well,
holy knows about that.
Yeah. Go on. Sand King's still in the pool. Probably get banned. I wonder. It's a possibility, I guess, still that they might do their whole sniper brood thing. They did this like two matches ago.
Yeah, I saw it.
Pretty strong strategy. Obviously, the sniper with the phase boots and Django taken out of Complexity's obviously. Book.
10 seconds oh, yeah.
Remaining. No, that's what I was saying, yeah, obviously. Don't worry, I called him out on it in the next lobby, too. I got you guys back. Anyway, so let's see. Maybe Sand King ban here. If not, I would expect Sand King to get picked up. Obviously, Beastmaster can do a decent job against Brood in the side lane, but certainly not as well as Sand King, so... Mize. Unfortunately, if you take the Sand King, you really just got no damage. I mean, well, you've got the Epicenter, which can be damaged, but no real damage. So then your last hero really has to fill that gap.
Yeah, I don't think we've really seen a hard carry come out from Pain so far. That mute is so loud. I don't blame you, though, because I know what you're doing.
No, your mute was really loud, too, though. I could hear you kept clicking on and off. Yeah. Definitely hear that. No, that wasn't. I'm done stuffing the face. That was actually the very satisfying drink of milk after.
Ooh, I'm jealous.
Uh huh. Well,
milk is my favorite.
Oh, I love milk so much. Yeah, all right. So another weird thing that happened to me when I came here. So the first time I go grocery shopping with the girlfriend, she picks up like this cart or this thing of milk. It's like six milks, and they're just sitting out, like not refrigerated at all. Just sitting out. Room temperature milk, which to me is just the weirdest thing ever. But it turns out here that it's this, I don't know if you've heard of this, but flash pasteurized.
Oh, it can survive the
water. Yeah. It's perfect. Once you open it, it needs to be refrigerated. But until it's opened, it's actually perfectly fine.
Oh, I've heard of that, right.
Yeah, but it to me, this was just the strangest thing ever. It took me 6 months at least to adapt to being willing to drink something like this. Because, you know, I'm always used to milk having to be cold. And yeah, it was just weird. But
wait, so you don't drink cold milk?
No, I do. We put it in the fridge first before opening it, obviously. Yeah.
Question. Is your girlfriend French?
She's Belgian, but French-Belgian, so essentially French.
Does she have a cool accent?
She does not. She can do the cool accent really well. Anti-mage. And there's that damage that we were talking about. So anti-mage, actually. Shadow Demon's still in the pool. We'll see if the Shadow Demon pick comes out. Ricky was banned, so I guess, yeah. You ban Ricky and you ban Enchantress to counter the Anti-Mage. Obviously, Ricky, just a direct counter to the Anti-Mage, and the Enchantress very strong against Anti-Mage with the pure damage later on. So, should have seen that one coming. A little unfocused. My bad.
Can't blame you.
Yeah, not doing my job so well.
So, wait, she's full... Wait, she's like American? Or where did she grow up?
No. She's... French or Belgian nationality. She's grown up in Belgium and France.
So you said she doesn't have an accent. What do you mean? Does she not speak English?
No, she speaks English fluently. She's I don't know. She sounds like an American when she speaks.
What? Mm-hmm. I think she's lying to you. I think you need to get to know this girl a little bit better.
Well, I've lived with her for 9 months, so I think by now she would have slipped.
5 seconds. Oh no, not slipped. I mean like. I think you don't know where she's born.
No, trust me. When I first met her, she did not speak English very well. But she still never had the accent. I don't know. I guess Belgium's kind of neutral.
Wait, she didn't speak English very well, but she didn't have an accent at the same time?
Correct.
That makes absolutely zero sense.
You can just not understand what the words are and not be able to say the correct words, but
Honestly, I guess that's possible because, I mean, I took Spanish, and I'm by no means fluent in Spanish, but when I do speak Spanish, I mean, I've been complimented by, you know, actual Spanish, like actual Mexicans, that I sound like I am from Mexico. Shut your mouth and do the video.
Yeah. So Shadow Demon picked anyway to counter the Anti-Mage. Didn't see that one coming.
Oh,
I did call this one. I did call this
one.
Oh,
you're clairvoyant as well.
Yeah. Man, I don't know how I could have ever seen that one coming. Sven. A little bit unusual.
I'm happy about that.
Yeah. Maybe that means they'll be doing an actual trial lane and the Lich will get a solo lane here? Possible. That is some next level by going old level metagame. Like, Lich solos is long time ago.
Oh, yeah. That is very complexity. Like, and by complexity, like, I mean just doing old Dota strategies. That's originality.
And they picked the Enigma against the Beastmaster. But, I mean, still, it's Enigma. So, and they're going to be able to push. They've got Brood and Enigma. All they're missing is the Lycan, and they would just have the sick minion strategy.
Yeah. I'm glad there's no Lycan. The Lycan's just so...
Oh, yeah.
How is that balanced?
Not balanced at all. Nothing about that hero is balanced. Howl is completely unbalanced. The Wolves are extremely unbalanced. His ultimate is quite unbalanced. The only thing that's actually moderately balanced is the passive. Although that's actually really unbalanced too, because of Puzzle Box. Oh my god. Necronomicon.
Uh-oh. What did you do?
I said...
Alright.
Yeah, I know.
What have you done? Alright, well, let's go over who's playing what. Have Fun Americans is the Brazilian.
Okay, well, I will take care of it this time. I got it. Alright, playing for Pain on the Radiant. The Green Trunks. Oh, you like how I stole that one from you.
Wow.
We've got Pada on the Lich. Bogus playing the Beastmaster. Grent.
Have you been in the last several games?
Yeah, you don't understand. My vision is literally blurring when I try to read these names by now. I'm probably going cross-eyed as we speak. Anyway, Grent. On the Crystal Maiden, Pride playing the Sven, and Doodoo on the Anti-Mage. And the Pride playing the Sven actually indicates to me that there's a possibility that they will be going for... Well, I mean, not a possibility. If you look at the lanes, they're going to have a dual lane mid with the Lich, and then they're going to have a dual lane Sven bottom. It means that they are going to be making some sort of a farming Sven, which means that you might be seeing some Great Cleave Ancient Stacking, potentially. Anyway, on Dire, none other than Dilated Mind himself playing the Tide... same here he played
the
last
Americans
game.
In the Red Trunks. Forgot it.
The Americans, yeah. That too. Okay. Chopper the Deer playing Leshrac. Derp on the Shadow Demon, WSLK on Enigma, and Sexy playing the Brood. Who, by the way, has gone Soul Ring recipe, our first item. I personally really do not like this. I think you don't have enough right-click damage to get some early hits, or early last hits, which I feel like you really need. How do you feel about this one?
Well, he's going to be against Sven, who has 63 base damage versus 49, so a huge difference, and it's a dual lane as well. So we will certainly see if your concern is valid or not right now.
Well, but...
There you go. He can come out of Invis and get a last hit. That's what the benefit is.
Yeah, but the problem I normally have with him coming out of Invis and getting the last hit is if he doesn't have enough right-click damage, he actually just can't get the last hit because they can just deny it. But... The good point about actually with being against the Sven, with Sven having such high right-click damage, I guess maybe it just doesn't matter so much, and it's just rushing that Soul Ring as quickly as possible that's going to allow him to stay in this lane.
Oh, Grent! Grent, too slow on the stack. That's embarrassing. Everyone look at Grent. Ha ha ha. Just kidding. Alright. Well, we're going to have a dual-laned mid against Shadow Demon. It's not a max range support, so... Derp should still be able to get some last hits and or some harassing, but after a couple levels on Lich, it's going to be really painful after that Q starts hurting. Meanwhile, up top, it is a dual lane with a jungler as well, so that's extremely dangerous. Beast solo Beastmaster. Pretty common to see that actually against, Brood. Not so much a Sven, but then again, I mean, there's really no one great that you can put in this lane if you're... Beastmaster, if you're the Radiant, I guess Beastmaster is the best choice.
Mm-hmm. I was wondering, actually, I mean, the Anti-Mage obviously had the Blink level 1. I was wondering if he would actually save his skill points and not get Mana Break, since he's up against the Shadow Demon in the lane, you know, obviously for fear of being able to be disruptioned and having all that Mana Burn turning against him, but he's actually opted to get it instead. I would have been really impressed to see him actually not pick that up. That would have certainly been entertaining, but sadly that's not the case.
Oh, too bad. Too bad. And let's see, how far away is this sexy from Sol? Oh, I'm gonna get it, Sandit! Oh, he snagged it. Got one more nice. Creep hit, or that's a couple more seconds, and he has it. So, well, not too bad. How many Lysium?
No, he doesn't have it. He still needs the... So, he has the Sobe Mask. He still needs the Ring of Regen.
He's a little while.
Yeah. Got a ways to go on that one.
He has 3 last hits, that's what he has. Ooh, that's pretty tough. Well, the lane is pushing now because of that failed pull, the failed to stack. It's gonna make it a lot easier for Sexy.
Stack successfully this time, though.
Good job. It's very hard to do.
Yeah.
Oh my god, no he didn't!
He failed it again.
What was that? It's like he pulled it. It's like he did half of both.
Yeah, well, he realized that he pulled it to stack. He realized he stacked like a second too soon and that it was going to get the range creep, so he kind of like stutter-stopped to try to prevent the range creep from aggroing, but it was too late, and yeah. 2 failed pulls in a row, so he's just as tired as we are.
Apparently, yeah, and it's... Well, I don't know what time it is in BR. Brasilia. Ooh, there's that mana burn coming out doing work. There's actually no more mana on Dudu either. But Derpter managed to pay for it. He might go down first blood. One more hit is going to be go down. Indeed, it's going to be taken by Lich. Lich will
be looking up at the grass.
What you got, Lich? Well, nice job, either way. 3-man gank in mid.
This should give the Brood some good time to farm bottom, but Sven has a kind of nice early advantage. I got the Basilius on Sven. A little bit unusual in that regard. You don't normally see Basilius is on strength heroes. That's because you don't normally see strength heroes in this role, so I guess that's why that is.
Well, I really like Sven, honestly, in this situation. At least a Sven that gets cleave.
Yeah.
Because it does great against Invis. It's absolutely wonders.
Yeah, and you know, it does great spiders against as well.
Yeah. That's what I meant, really. Not so much as by Invis, as it does great against Brood.
Mm-hmm.
Is what I meant. VR.
Alright. I like this guy.
So now it's actually him crashing. It's not just Brazil. You can't blame Brazil for this one. I don't know why they do.
No, because they're saying that it's Brazilian internet that's causing this guy to crash.
Well, are they? Because he said crashing. He didn't say it was Brazilian. He didn't say it was internet crash. He said it could be computer crash.
Oh, well, then it's Brazilian computer.
I think you're probably right, though. I think it's more likely probably for it to be...
With how quickly internet. He gets back into the game, I think it's got to be the internet, not the computer.
I think you're probably right. I concede.
Yeah.
I know when I'm wrong, right?
Alright, so we got a gank. Yeah. A gank coming bottom. He actually, the CM does have another sentry, so they should be able to pick up this brood kill, assuming the brood doesn't get spooked here.
Spooked.
Yeah, no. I what actually... What did you say?
I'm just going to repeat everything you say.
I thought trees respawn every 6 minutes.
Oh, it's different. It's different. I don't know what it is.
Okay, because, yeah, there's this web here on the left that was clearly used to block down the trees, but it's actually, they're back up now, so it's weird.
Yeah, I need to look into it. I need to wake up. But I need to look into that because that's something I don't know for 100% in Dota 2, is how trees respawn.
And also, interesting...
Well, I just got time right now, so continue talking.
I'll go look as far as the recipe Sol Ring first item goes, the Beastmaster has actually opted for this as well, which is really strange. And, I mean, it's not really strange, but it's quite strange. And also strange is that he's actually gone one level in Inner Beast, rather than his summons, which is perfectly normal these days for a mid-Beastmaster, because the idea, obviously, is that the passive helps push the lane, and by pushing the lane, it makes it easier for you to go rune control. But in this case, he's solo top, so that passive attack speed aura is actually not going to do anything good for him. And that's a little bit strange.
All right, well, I got the answer. No, especially continue. I thought you were done.
I was going to say, especially with how important having his, you know, Hawk is. It's the reason you get Beastmaster.
Yeah. All right, we're going to
have a gank
here. Sexy should be going down here for sure. He's underneath the ward and the sun. Nice. Look at this. That's such a brutal tri lane right there. There's not really anybody that's going to survive that. But By the way, as I was saying, there's nothing else going on. Trees respawn 5 minutes after they were destroyed. It's that simple. They just respawn 5 minutes after they were destroyed.
Okay.
So that makes sense.
Yep, that works. Yep. Where'd you find that out? Dev Dota 2 or?
Oh no, I can't give you my source. Otherwise, everybody will be smart like me.
Ooh. Can you give me my your source in private?
Yes. You know what? I might as well shout it out because they deserve it. Just Dota2wiki.com.
Oh, okay.
Did you know about that site?
Yeah, yeah. I went there for info on some competitive team, and they had, like, nothing for me. I was pretty disappointed.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought they were pretty good on that.
I don't remember who it was or what exactly it was, but I do remember going there once, and it didn't give me exactly... Or it didn't give me what I wanted at all. Maybe it was... I don't know. Maybe it had something to do with Panda. Maybe not a competitive team. I don't really remember.
Yeah.
This point.
I mean, it's definitely no game replays. It was a newer competitive wiki, is what you're saying.
Well, what can I say? That wiki was pretty boss.
Yeah, it was.
Well, anyway.
What the hell?
What?
I don't know. That was my mic. My computer just freaked out a little bit there. Anyways, nothing. I'm still here, fortunately, but I thought my computer froze. It's weird.
Okay. Well. Good it didn't. Yeah, so the Sven still has not picked up any points in Cleave. I agree, I would like to see him Cleave. Or get Cleave. I'd like to see him Cleave. Plus it's so entertaining. Instead he's just using his Stormbolt. Is it called Storm? Oh. No, Stormhammer in this. Oh. Is Stormbolt really copyrighted?
Copyrighted.
Really? Can we say that? Oh my god. Okay.
Good old Blizzard.
His Stormhammer. To kill the spiders instead, which I guess helps further explain his Basilius. I would like to see him tread swap then if he's going to actually keep spamming an ability like that. I mean, it should be pretty easy to do and get a little more mana efficiency, because otherwise he's going to run out pretty quickly here. Sven, certainly not known for his copious mana pool.
Nope, he's definitely not. We've got two people waiting in the flanks in mid here. My spider sense...
Top, Beastmaster is going to die. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Ravage, Dilated Mine had to pop the Ravage.
Oh, look at that, look at Rosh. Nerdy Brazilians. Unsuccessful.
This is North Americans, not Brazilians.
Oh, well fine, nerdy Americans then, whatever. They're known for being nerdy as well. But this isn't even going to work, any more spiders.
No, it works because you can keep converting the Eidolons.
With enough mana. Oh, yeah, look how much mana he has. He's got Slowering and Basilius.
No, it's actually possible for an Enigma with level 7, level 3 levels of, or 4 levels of conversion. It's actually Solar Rosh.
Wow. This shows you how little I know.
Yeah, but it's very early done because it requires a lot of commitment. It's very easy to, if you suspect it, to just come kill him. But it's going to work. He's just got to make sure he keeps one Eidolon alive here, which he will do. And it's very important that he doesn't get bashed, because if he gets bashed right when he wants to convert that Eidolon, there we go. And then it failed. But no, it doesn't. And he's going to get bashed.
No! Oh, that's an ally. Never mind.
Oh, that would be so terrible. That would be the worst. All the work he does to take that. Although I'm still a little disappointed that they give this this Aegis to Dilated Mind there, though, because you know what? All that work that Enigma did to Solar Rush there, he deserves the friggin' Aegis, not some stupid Tide. What does Tide even need an Aegis for? I mean, well, he doesn't have any points in Kraken Shell, so that's what he needs an Aegis for.
All right, well, that was pretty cool. I've actually never seen that live, or in general, never seen it. Not gonna lie.
Yeah, well, I learned that one first from a pub game. Whoa, actually, we got a big Ancient Sack here. Beastmaster doing the Ancient trick, but it's not going to work out so well because he's been found out.
Oh, no.
Oh, please. Oh, that would have been too good.
Oh, my God. Delated is, you know what? He is known, I'm going to say this, he is known for just being careless with Aegis. Like, he's known for that. Like, the games I've seen him play, which have several today alone, he's just, when he has Aegis, he just is, way too aggressive, way too careless, but, alright, whatever, he gave that away, literally, he did.
Yeah, I'd be quite pissed if I was that Enigma right now, I'd be quite pissed.
I know.
Like, you son of a bitch, how could you do that to me? All that work and, they are gonna steal these Ancients though, or they're gonna try to at least, and Edict will be up in 2 seconds, which will really facilitate this process.
Wow, Fen is running, he's on the run, that's how important it is to them. Sven is like, I'm coming, guys!
Regeneration.
The worst part is he's turning back now. he made it 2/3 of the way there, and there's like, no, bro, we don't need you anymore. You can go back. And he's like, oh no. And he runs all the way back down to the bottom where the brew is just like, okay, come to me.
This guy. Look at him go. Oh, he swapped it a little bit. Uh-oh, we're gonna have a little bit of a deny here, I feel. I sense a deny.
Well, the question is whether he'll ult to deny to beat the Brood for it, or whether it's gonna be straight up deny. Brood's gotta be thinking about going for this one, although sees the CM there, so yeah, just gonna... Yeah.
Radiant's bottom tower has been denied. Nice deny.
Yeah. I was yawning in the
alarm. My button is not very handy, unfortunately.
Yeah, well, I can mute, but you were saying how loud it is, so I was avoiding the mute.
Yeah, I guess it is. I don't know. Of all things, why would mute be loud?
I don't know. It doesn't make much sense, does it?
I don't know what it is. I don't know. Anyways, go ahead. It sounds like you're actually going to try casting, so, I mean, that's what I'm doing. So carry on.
Anyway, well, yeah, it looks like Sven has decided to go for Urn. Yeah, I mean, pretty standard. You want to have Urn on someone on your team. And 500 gold, I would assume he's probably going to go Blink next.
Oh my god, your voice is so spent. It's just funny listening to you. You're just like... I feel so... Like, you need to be getting paid for this.
You know what? I couldn't agree more. I need to either one or the other here to have more than 50 viewers or to be getting paid. Let's be real here. Spending 7 hours straight casting for no money and no viewers is quite deflating.
Oh, my face hurts. I'm smiling too much. No, you're so true. It's so true, dude. Yeah, I don't.
Well, Shrek stun doesn't come in time.
It's a fair. I mean, it is DreamHack. You can't.
Yeah.
Can't expect much. But now we're gonna lose about 40 viewers. Cause, oh shit! It's DreamHack.
Yeah, wait! DreamHack's on. And we're on.
They're probably just dual screening anyways, like we're muted. Check.
No, yeah, let's be honest, they're all watching the Swedish stream at this point anyway. Even if they can't understand it. I guess they figured that they would rather have people speaking nonsense that they can't understand, but that it actually has to do with the game, rather than people speaking nonsense they can understand and know has nothing to do with the game.
Alright, well, heavy push coming out here from... The North or the Americans, not the North. We're just gonna go with Americans. I've heard a lot of foreigners say, anyways, like it doesn't even make sense to call Canada, and you know, it doesn't even make sense to call it North America. Just call it America, anyways, because I guess, and this isn't even my perspective, but it seems like from the foreign perspective, it seems like people view Canada as just like an extension of America, anyways.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Well. I mean, yeah, because, well, technically America refers to a continent, not an actual country. It's the U.S., but it's so difficult. This is a problem I run into all the time of actually, like, are you supposed to, like, yeah, say you're American? I mean, because are you really going to say, no, I'm a citizen of the United States? Like, who does that?
I'm dorky, no one does.
So, yeah, exactly. Yeah, so, I mean, yeah, well, so I think just saying it's American anyway is perfectly fine. I get your point there, because even if you're not looking at it from that, or looking at it from the route of, yeah, I mean, people just kind of group the two together in that regard. I mean, looking at it as being all part of North America, which you're just shortening to America, is fine anyway, so.
Yeah. And you know, the United States of America, they don't refer to themselves, they're not the USA anymore. You know, they've dropped the A for years now.
Really?
Yeah, at least when people refer to the U.S., if you ever look at any around, it's no longer United States of America, because that was too, you know, like we're hogging the continent. United States.
Yeah, I gotcha.
You know.
Yeah, I get what you're saying there.
How long have you been in France?
It's the end of April, so actually 11 months.
And why are you there?
Because I can. I don't know.
That's all you need. There's no. I mean, I was just wondering. Maybe it was school or work or something.
No. Well, no. I mean, I was an English major, so I can. I mean, the job prospects in the U.S. are pretty limited for English teachers. Which, yeah, I was an English major to be an English teacher.
Uh-huh. Well, I assume you speak French or something.
Yeah, I do now. Although I just learned it while being here. I don't know. No, I.
Job yet that utilizes English majoring.
Yeah. I guess. Well, no. I mean, I teach English here, obviously.
Okay.
To foreigners, although it's not actually what I studied. And so, if you click on Enigma right now, does he look really funky to you, or is that just my screen messing up?
No, it's fine.
For me, he's like all black, really weird looking. Anyway, yeah. Well, I don't know. Before this, I was traveling and I was in Asia for a while, and then got the opportunity to come here. So.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, well, I'm from originally Peoria, Illinois, which you probably don't know, but it's like right in the middle of Illinois with absolutely nothing. And so the opportunity to come live in like one of the most famous cities in the world, it's certainly an upgrade.
Absolutely. Ooh, we got a TP in the middle of everyone. Who is that? Oh, BM. BM's going to actually grab the ult there on Deer, followed up by Pride Stun. Oh! Go back, Pride! Pride, go back! Well, that was a clutch.
Disruption. Yeah, that was real nice. Oh, I guess it would have been more clutch if the projectile was actually in motion.
That would have been even truer.
Yeah. Even clutcher?
More clutch. Even truer, yeah. Wow. Grammar out the window right now.
Yeah. So, drums on Shadow Demon, that's pretty unusual. I mean, I guess he just didn't have a very easy time mid early on, so he wanted the bracer, and well, when you make bracer, why not make drums?
Fair enough. Although he does have another gauntlet. What the hell's that about?
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I think he went the purge dual gauntlet to get an urn on Shadow Demon mid build. And
you know what I'm realizing right now live? I'm realizing that I have potentially the shortest caster attention span of them all. Like, there is no one worse than me at all. You are a trooper. Like, you want to know what it is? I literally think my caster attention span is 2 games. Not 2 matches. 2 games. That is... I don't know. I need to take some Adderall or Ritalin or something, maybe. That might help. Because as it is right now, we got an Invis. Derp. He actually gets spotted. He's disrupted, though. He's going to die.
Yeah, that's not going to end well for him. Ooh, but that is.
Ooh, nice. Grant's going to go down. He's going to be at least right. Oh, no, he's not. What was that? That was a magic wand. Nicely done. He's going to save his own life. And nice. A little bit of one-for-none exchange there in the favor of the Brazilians.
And a wasted title. So this 18-minute 3-1 game just turned into an 18-minute 4-1 game.
Oh, and we've actually like watching League.
Yeah, increased by 20. Oh. Fortunately, I have never actually once in my life ever watched a game of League, so it's not.
I have. And this is typical.
Career snipe. It's so close.
Nope. Not happening. This 4-1 in 18 minutes is a typical like League game. Anyway, oh, but you know, hey, League is popular as F, so whatever.
Yeah.
There's no reason.
All right. Anyway, yeah. Yeah, after hearing the casters, I'm sure he's going to be very inclined to give you that totally. Anyway, what?
We can try hard.
Oh, yeah, so 2 games ago or last... No, yeah, it was 2 games. In the previous match, Sexy, also playing Brood, went Fast Boots of Travel. Went basically this exact same build. Soul Ring into Boots and then went Travels. And Travels on Brood is just something that I am just appalled by. Like, it is appalling to my senses to see a Brood get Travels, because I do not understand, even to the slightest, what the purpose of this is. Ooh, and actually, we're going to have some action.
We've got Smoke Gang coming in. The Brazilians are coming in. They're going to go ahead and throw axes in. Who is he going to ult? Oh, look, they're going to kill WSLK before he can do anything. He's going to go down. Now Dirt Drip comes out, trying to lay some poison down, but he's going to probably die as well. Mech actually comes out. Mech from Lesh, that was in range. And now Duda comes in to finish it off. So wow, 2-for-none exchange. Please don't blow your ult here. That would be bad. Ooh, he gets a blink off right before that auto attack lands. And yeah, so that was a nice little smoke gank maneuver. Although, to be fair, I don't actually think they smoked. I guess they did a little bit. No, that ward was just put up. Never mind. So smoked, actually. Don't you hate that when you smoke and you win a team fight and you think that you got there because of something Smoke did, but it was actually nothing at all that Smoke did. That's, like, misleading. Anyways, nice play there, regardless.
Yeah, but then on the plus side, you won the team fight, so I think you get over it regardless.
Yeah.
Invisibility.
Mm.
62. Okay.
So, back to the point I wanted to bring up. So now that I have someone someone else to ask about this, because I asked Gino about it, and he kind of wanted to err on the side of the players. I think, I mean, he, you know, wanted to give them the benefit of the
doubt.
Hell
with that. I'll give you an honest answer.
Exactly. I give no benefit of the doubt. In my opinion, Travels on Brood is terrible. Now, I understand the idea Brood is a split pusher or whatever, but Brood is a split pusher who sits in the entire lane or lane slash jungle the entire game, or at least, the same lane the entire game, at least until she has BKB. And then when she has BKB, she can worry about TPing and actually team fighting, maybe. Although really, not so much. You're still going to just get, son of a bitch. All right, more action. We'll get back to this point.
Team fight. Oh, nice Vance stun. Oh, but it doesn't matter. That would have been enough if Delayed didn't have a great ult. Oh, wow. Randomly unlucky ult being canceled there by the pot of ult lich. And this is, honestly, they're probably just going to part ways here, but wow, that was an unlucky right there. Enigma had a pretty decent ult and just completely unlucky. And you know what's different, by the way, is how Chain stun, when it stuns in Dota 2 as opposed to Han and Dota 1, I believe in Dota 1 as well, as in Han, the chain, it was instant. Like, the second you casted the ult, it was not so here. So, I mean, that's a tiny bit of a nerf. Obviously not in this case, but I guess in this case it actually was it was the opposite. It was a buff, yeah. Either way, unlucky. But could have been really bad if Tide did not get that nice ult off, because Sven had landed a nice stun right there. But I want to hear. So you want to present
I want no. Basically, I want your either rebuttal or response to this. I position that Travels on Brood are absolutely terrible, and that there's absolutely no reason to get it. Gino proposed that, yeah, well, then you can go to the other lane and push that too or something like that. But no, you can't. You can't do that as Brood because you need your webs up. Like, you can't just switch to a different lane and start pushing that because you don't have webs there. So it just doesn't really work. I was right because in the previous game, he got these and he absolutely never used them. But, I mean, can you defend this or no?
Well, I mean, we're going to see, because he's going Radiance. You don't always see Radiance on Brood. I mean, I don't know if it's recommended in this game.
Yeah,
I know, I wouldn't be surprised if it is, yeah. But regardless if it's being recommended, you don't always see it. So he is going to be the epitome of a pusher. They're building him as a pusher with that Radiance. So maybe it makes more sense with the Radiance in the item build. But in general, I mean, I'm going to have to side with the fact that he is completely reliant upon his webs. So what's the cooldown on those? 30 seconds.
It's like a 30-second cooldown. So, I mean, you really can't get more than two webs up in a lane when you switch to it very effectively for, you know,
well, what about this, then? What about if you have two lines of webs, you know, you have, like, three bottom, three top, so to speak? I mean, then it would seem pretty viable at that point. Because the only thing holding it back, really, is webs. So if you were to go once, you know, put, you know, and stay for a minute and a half and lay down three webs in a, you know, in a nice area or whatever, then from that point on, I don't hate it. Let's put it that way. I don't hate it.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, well, I mean, that is the best argument you can make for it, is the idea of putting, three webs or four webs in each of the two lanes, because four webs is probably enough to cover the area of the lane that you really care about. So, I mean, that's fine. But he's definitely not doing that. There is none of that happening. He just actually gets Travels because he's like, you know what, I can buy Travels. The previous game, he did go BKB after Travels and then Radiance. This time he's just going the fast Radiance, and I do not like. I mean, it doesn't really matter anyway because he's just Brood, and this hero is ridiculous when people don't address it correctly. And, well, it has not been addressed correctly here. So, I mean, he could just buy, like, three Relics and still be fine.
Well, yeah, since we're on the subject of that, let's actually just hold F4, open up Golden Minutes, let's actually see how bad it is. This is at 356, you know, that's definitely not out of hand by any means. Enigma, on the other hand, is farming very well, 330, and then, wow, I mean, the Dire, obviously, 3,700 gold compared to, that's a pretty big deficit, almost 10,000 now. And let's go to items, see what we got going on. We got Pipe on Beastmaster, nothing else above or below him. Wow. Not a whole lot to go around whatsoever for the Brazilians. This is looking pretty bad for the Brazilians. Meanwhile, we've got Blink, Urn, Arcane Boots, Perseverance, Point Booster, all on Tide. And then we've got Mech, Point Booster.
Excellent, Roche.
Oh, whoa. Roche, what's going on? It's delayed, get your ult off. Deleted! He gets his ult off, he lands it on a couple people. Not to much effect, unfortunately, though. Chopper the Deer now on the run. Trying to do what he can to do, having, again, pretty much no effect on Sven. I like how they split. Basically, the Radiant split the Dire into two different halves, and they completely picked apart both halves. Now the three go down, just for a Lich, really, and they're also going to get this this Roshan. So this is looking very, very, very good for the Americans.
Because for Brazil, I was just going to scream,
sorry. No,
Brazil!
No, sorry.
And you ruined it for me completely by saying for the Americans.
Well, okay, sorry. For the South Americans!
Brazil!
That's what I meant.
Okay, there
yeah.
we go.
Yeah.
So, Anti-Mage has Perseverance. maybe going for Battle Fury. Maybe going for Lincolns.
I would be happy with Battle Fury here against a Brood.
Yeah. It's a little bit late. Oh, wow. Look at these Swedish casters. They're so good. They're so much better than we are. They're riding down the Roche timer. Although, they wrote it wrong, because it's definitely not... yeah, tier 1 casters for sure.
Oh, not yet. I'll come out. Thanks. That's my roommate giving me food. Isn't he nice?
That is awesome.
Literally, literally walking in with food in his hand. A quesadilla.
You know, I almost made a quesadilla, but my girlfriend said it would take too long. She's probably right.
Of course it would. It would take way too long. What are you going to do? Like, well, I guess it depends on how hardcore you are, but anyways.
But yeah, well, no, she's normally quite amazing as well. Normally when I cast, she'll, yeah, like, cook something for me and let me eat it, which is awesome of her.
Where's she now?
she's in the other room. She can't actually hear that I'm brown-nosing her right now, so I'm not getting anything out of this. I've heard your wife, what was it that time that, yeah, like, we were playing an in-house with Holy? Oh, he does have the Battle Fury finished on the AM. Anyway, we're playing an in-house with Holy for, like, the first time, and he's playing, so with some people that don't really know him. And they're drafting on the other team. And I start getting messages from these guys who are saying that instead of actually worrying about the picks or bans, all he's worrying about is yelling stuff to his wife, like, you just hate me because I'm black.
And Holy? Oh, God. Holy says no comment.
Yeah, because they can't hear him. So, yeah. Yeah, at that point, I guess this was the lure of a false sense of security, because I assumed that there was basically no way I could lose this game, so I could just pick whatever I wanted, etc. And it actually ended up losing this to the person who, instead of picking and banning, just was yelling at his wife.
Now, the best part is not the interaction between him and his wife, although I will give you that it is hilarious regardless. It's when his kids just walk. He just gives his kids whatever he wants. It's so great. I love it. I love listening to it. It's like Holy he's such a friend to his kids that he doesn't ever say no. It's so great.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, just like I think it was last night or the night before, one of his kids kept wanting ice milk, I think it was, or something, and Holy kept having to explain that no, there's no ice milk or something like that. I don't remember exactly what it was, but yeah, he was so compassionate. See, me, I would have been the complete opposite. I hate kids. Fortunately, I've never had one. Oh, yeah, I am so anti. All right, well, kids I'm all right with. Like, my rule is once a child's 5 years old, I'm willing to
raise it. With you. Dude, I am so with you. No, for me, it's after diapers. I just...
If
you can get to, like, 4 or 3, if diapers are done, I'm down. Like, I want to be able to, like, fight with my kids. Like, I remember when I was young, I would, like, wrestle with my dad, and I have a twin sister. We would my dad would scare the hell out of us, and that was, like, that was fun.
Yeah, I like that, and I want to be able to teach, my child about playing basketball and stuff like this, but...
Yeah, well, we've got some parenting going on now. Look at we're just, like, Dr. Phil Dota casters. You don't know what Dr. Phil is, do you?
Of course I know what Dr. Phil is.
I don't know. You don't know what kind of programming you have over there.
Okay, I haven't lived here my whole life.
Okay, I forgot. Sorry, you're not a Frenchie.
Yeah.
Oh, Holy knows Dr. Phil. Wow,
yeah,
Dr.
Phil
hated it.
And he's British, so that's saying something.
Is he? Dr. Phil's British?
No, Holy's British.
Oh, Holy. Okay, I'm like, wait, I'm pretty sure he is American. All right, okay. Yeah. Anyways. Okay, well, I'm glad that everyone got that then. At least the people involved in creating this got it, not necessarily all the viewers. Mm-hmm. But, you know, if Holy got it, I'm assuming everyone got it. Yeah. Oh, Blink. Oh, okay.
Wait, Blink? Oh. Speaking of Blinks, Sven decided to go for the BKB first, which I guess, you know, I kind of expected that to be the case, but I would hope to see a Blink from him soon here. I would like to. I mean, he should. I don't know. It seems like it would be a good plan. Give them some nice initiation. Let him really crush people with his ult right in the face rather than running at them very slowly with a not-so-effective ult. I don't know.
Yeah, he... four staff much? No, I guess that's just, somebody censor that. He didn't really say that. What is it with these? Is it just the combination of these two teams? It's gotta be.
We're guessing some chess and
stuff. that reminds me, my other roommate, he just got back into Magic the Gathering online or something, and I was like, dude, I was watching him play, and I was like, dude, this would be fun to cast, just like over the top cast, like, oh, and he taps mana, for those of you who know what that is. And, but yeah, it's like, it's a card game, it's not worth it.
Yeah, I played it when I was young.
I guess there's not much shame in saying that, considering we're casting a video game right now. I'm sure you're not alone.
Yeah, I'm not too embarrassed.
Yeah. All right, well, we've got a push. Oh my god, this seems to be some form of action unfolding right now. We've got,
it seems the Dire is going to back off.
Never mind, I spoke too soon. Oh, we'll see. Maybe they'll actually put up a fight here at tier 2. It's a little bit better of a... Okay, nope, they're gonna let it go. They're gonna relinquish. Oh, no, we got a TP coming in.
Tide's gonna come.
Tide with the blink. Both the blinks are already. The ults are ready. We'll see if they can do anything. Oh, blink ult. He grabs two. The follow-up. Oh, he's gonna grab it. Where's the ult? Oh, the ult comes out, but it is not aimed at WSLK, so he's gonna get a full ult off, and that is indeed gonna be a victorious team fight here. At least it should be. Dude is gonna go down one blink. That's not... Is that the real Dudu? Where's Dudu? Oh, no, yeah, what's the real Dudu?
Yeah,
he's
real
Dudu.
He's got
all right,
the agents.
All right.
Yeah, well. Dudu actually had the opportunity there to ult the Enigma, and instead decided to ult the Tide.
I was also talking about Pata, actually. Pata, as well. Lucky. His ult had already gone out. I feel like he should have saved the ult, honestly.
Oh, well, but I mean, he didn't need to, because the Anti-Mage actually was off on the side, and, you know, Anti-Mage's ult does have a mini-stun, so he could have actually broken the Enigma ult, and he... Well after the Enigma ult had started, but well before it was over, he opted to ult the Tide instead, so... Costing his team a bit there.
Definitely. Well, they got a tower, but they ended up losing, and then the half damage, like two-thirds, two with the second-tier tower. But and now we're going to go back to another period of about 30 minutes of talking about anything un-Dota-related.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it's your turn to supply this. I've carried the last
supply.
Couple of
weeks. And yeah. I'm the catalyst for every subject, I think, probably. What are you talking about? I guess I mean, it probably means I need to find a new subject, though, is a thing.
Yeah, that's just as good of an argument. I can go back to politics. There's an election that's happening here now in France, and it is not a good situation at all. The current president, I think he's the president. Yeah, I'm going to assume that. It's not prime minister. Yeah, it's president. I'm sure it's president. The current president of France, Sarkozy, do you know anything about him? Because he is a huge idiot.
I don't. I'm an American.
Yes, he is. He's like France's George Bush, basically.
Okay. So does he get along with America?
Nah, not especially. I mean, I don't really know what his relation with is that. But he's basically just like a huge, huge idiot. For example, he claimed he was in Fukushima to like help with the relief efforts after the whole accident there, when he actually never was. He went to Tokyo and just didn't actually go at all. Like, he just basically, I don't know, he's lied about a lot of things, and basically, he was gaming in Tokyo. And so, I don't know, he's just terrible, but none of the candidates are any good. It's just, it's
that's
awful
exactly
right now.
Situation.
Yeah, but I feel like there's hope for Obama still to do something, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I don't know. I feel like if Obama gets reelected, there's still hope, you know? Romney getting elected, Romney's just, I don't don't know. I feel like he'll just say anything. I don't really know why I would ever elect him. He just,
that's,
I mean,
how
I don't...
I feel about every politician on
Yeah, yeah, well, no, absolutely. Don't get me wrong. I think, in general, one of the reasons people are so disappointed with Obama is because they thought he would actually
because
be, like, different.
That's what he did. He said whatever it took to get in. But you know what? Don't hate the game, I guess, not the player, right? Because that's what you got to do to get elected. That's the sad fact of it. And it's like, that's why I despise. This year, I'm 27, and this is the first year I'm actually contemplating not voting because I'm so just disgusted with the entire concept. But
yeah, well, generally speaking, I buy into the whole argument that, you know, if you don't vote, you can't complain. But at the same time, if I don't vote, I can't be blamed.
True.
So, I don't know.
That's a new way to look at it.
Yeah. Oh.
You got it wrong.
Again. Wait.
No.
Oh. It's not showing it came back up?
Yeah. There's no manners on us either.
Well, let's be honest. Someone who they can't even hear one. But yeah, someone who rides a polar bear has no fear of offending people. So they just have no manners. They ride polar bears. Come on.
Ferocious.
Yeah, it is ferocious. Anti-mage has Manta.
I'm about to alt chat some fucking unmannered shit right now and just be like. Hurry!
Jesus Christ! You two, fight each other now! Just like, start picking people, one person on one team, one person on the other team, you two, mid, now, and then like, send the next two, and the next two, and the next two, and whichever team wins more of the five,
just
one versus one matchup,
wins
the game.
Make it a Pokemon match.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, yeah.
Oh my god, that should be a mode!
That would be entertaining.
That would be amazing.
Actually. Yeah, like, you have to send out the different heroes, and so, like, there's actually some strategy to that.
Huh. Oh, yeah. Oh my god, Valve?
Introduce Pokemon mode?
There's probably a decent name for it, like...
Battle like mode? Arena mode?
Challenge mode?
Brazilian arena mode?
Alright, well, we're gonna see the Americans. Our cameraman is unhappy. Our cameraman's about to lose it. All right, well, we're gonna hopefully have some action here until they back off. Someone needs to commit to the Rosh attack. We've got greater boar. It's very cute, actually, the way he prances. So, do you watch Game of Thrones?
I do not, but I am reading it. I'm in the third book.
Holy loves it. Oh my god, it's so good.
Well, I mean, the books are amazing, so I don't see why the
show
would
be
good.
But... I was talking about this with my dad, like, you know, Hunger Games. I liked the book a lot more than the movie. And don't get me wrong, I thought the movie was solid.
Did you really? Ugh.
I'll always say it was solid. I thought it was a solid movie.
Okay,
but I don't feel the same way for the Hunger Games. I seriously think that the Hunger Games, okay, actually, we're going to have an initiation here. Oh, he disrupts himself. Dodging the sun, nicely done. The sun was wasted. Lots of damage actually coming out. He's going to BKB to avoid all of it, though. Now we've got WSOK in the middle. Nice! Turns around. Great awareness. We'll see if we can have a follow-up here. Is Tide already dead or something? Where the hell is Tide? Tide is actually... Oh, my God. Tide is tunnel vision somewhere completely else. He was not in that fight, really, and his ult has not even been used. Wow, what a terrible, terrible...
And the courier snipe.
And the courier snipe. Wow, that was disappointing. I was really hoping for the follow-up there from Tide after that black hole. It was a really nice turnaround of the black hole, but... Tide was busy chasing Sam, apparently. But either way, we're going to see what is probably a Rosh kill here for the Brazilians. Woo! Brasilia!
So, as far as Hunger Games goes, I didn't read the books.
I'm sorry. It's just that, and it sounded like, you know, typically you're going to go, you can recap what just happened, but you go right to the Hunger Games. Like, action. Pride action. Look how slow this guy is. Oh my god, I'm trying to look at how slow he is. So maimed. So nicely done. They're actually Sexy's doing what he can. He's actually gonna grab another kill here. I wish I could psychopathically cast, because then I wouldn't have my mouse wouldn't have to work. But yeah. Oh wow, this is pretty bad now. Oh, go back to your web. Where's the cleave? He does have cleave. Too bad there's nothing to attack. That would have been enough.
There's a gem up there. There's a gem up there. Go grab the gem. Oh, the aim has... Yeah, he grabbed it. All right.
Too bad Tide... Oh, Tide is back, and he does have his ult. Oh, yeah. This could be bad. This could be bad. Go on, Tide. Tide, go in. Tide. Oh!
Here it comes. Yeah, there it is.
That was utterly useless. Utterly useless.
Oh, AM. No, don't leave, you pussy. Don't leave.
Oh, AM's going to give up the Roche.
He dropped the gem, not going to be able to give you enough.
Look at this. It's a melee for Roche. This is so important, too. Whoever gets this. Dire gets it.
But AM gets the Aegis. Wait, no. Beastmaster got the Aegis.
Did he?
Yeah, he did.
Did he use it?
No, he still has it. He's running out with it, but pretty... Crazy. Oh, wait, he got the cheese, too.
And the Aegis. He got...
yeah, so he's got a hold on
nice.
No, you dare use that cheese. All right. All right, here comes the stun. No stun because he's BKB'd, but you're just going to blast.
Oh my god, look at the damage from Pride. Oh my god.
Just
he is hitting so hard.
Stomp him.
Holy crap.
Oh, but now the Shadow Demon's
saying. He is now 4v1. And AM
doesn't matter, he's red. Dude, he's red.
Why is he red?
But
Is that his ult?
Yeah, his ult turns him red.
Okay, that is BA.
Yeah, of course. See, now he's blue again. Not really as cool. When he's red...
Well, anyways, I'm going to cut you off in the Hunger Games. So, what I was saying before... I mean, I'll let you have your point, but what I was saying is Hunger Games was a solid movie. The book was better. But I would argue that for the Game of Thrones, that, like, the HBO series is on par, like, with the reading experience. Like, it is... Like, they spared no expense. Like, this is one of the best TV series I've ever watched. So, you've got to watch it.
I can safely say that I...
That's not like every episode.
I've never watched in my entire life anything where I've ever felt that the show or the movie or whatever is as good as the book. So
you might be dissuaded. Right. Simon.
Well, we shall see. We shall see. Anyway, I'll start with my point about Hunger Games, which was that I've heard the books were very good, but I didn't actually read the books. And there's something else I wanted to say, but man, I can just not coherently put together thoughts at this point. My brain is just so fried. I have such an enormous headache. It feels like my head's going to explode. As far as the movies, oh my god, that chick is just so ugly. It's just
I know. Oh god,
she has the fattest face. And actually, not just does it turn out she has an enormously fat face, but she's also got these huge fat fingers. Like, it's not even man hands. They're like stumps. She's like Deadwood, basically. Like, if she punches you, it's like getting hit by a tree.
Oh, we have a blink, and he actually hits like four people that time. Nice. Oh, and the refresher comes out. Nicely done. Fried. Oh, he just pops cheese, and he is now going to town. Five hits, six hits. Is he going to get enough? No, Deer's actually going to get away. I'm looking at his friend, by the way. Bogus actually gets away as well. Going to throw out Axe. Is he going to pop? It is going to pop. He should be down. And he did. He does go down. The image is burning away. Okay, I need to probably find the real fight now. Pride actually going to go down as well. Wow, this is a one-sided fight. What the hell is going on? Why is America winning this? I thought Brazil was going to win this.
Yeah, Anti-Mage is just useless because they have Shadow Demon. Shadow Demon just disruptioning the Anti-Mage every time, and then you get two Anti-Mages. Because, like, Pride's, like, manning up there and doing stuff, and the Beastmaster made sure that the Enigma didn't get his ult off on anyone, but then meanwhile, like, the Anti-Mage is just like, oh, I just got disruptioned. Oh, these two things are just burning all my mana. Oh, now they're burning everyone else's mana, and...
All right, so you remember your Hunger Games point? Oh, no, the girl.
Yeah, it was just that I saw the cast, or I saw her, and she just, I could not stand. I did see the movie with the girlfriend because she wanted to, but really, it had originally had no strong desire to see it.
How bad is that? I mean, I have the same argument. I mean, I still went to see it. I still enjoyed it, but I still think it's a valid argument. Like, between the other, like, the Twilight movies, I had the same argument. Honestly, as sad as it may sound, that's why I never watched those. Because, what's her name? Like, Bella, is it?
Uh-huh.
Just not hot enough.
Yeah, Kristen Stewart. Yeah, well, that's a whole different kind of thing. Like, Kristen Stewart is definitely not attractive, but I find this chick to just be downright appalling. Like, she is... there is just something very... And Anti-Mage going for Heart now, which is a perfectly normal build progression from Battle Fury Manta, but not again, not when the problem is the Shadow Demon. But yeah, anyway, she actually just, like, she's appalling to my senses, like, so,
yeah,
I don't know.
I'm not going to disagree.
And so,
they really
yeah.
should have casted someone a little bit less repulsive.
Yeah, I don't know, I mean...
I wasn't even going to say more attractive, but less repulsive.
I was talking to someone else who read the books and liked them, and he said that he actually liked the casting of her because he said he hated her in the books. He felt like she was a huge cocktease, and so he liked the fact that he hated the person that was cast as her.
That's funny.
But,
Yeah, and that I was going to say that, and then there was one of the characters is just, in the book, he's large and strong and whatnot. I think his name is PETA. And in the movie, he's like this little pretty boy. Like, what the hell? How... He's supposed to be some huge, buff, strong guy, and in the movie he's like this blonde pretty boy. Like, really?
Oh wait, that the guy that she like kisses or whatever?
Yeah. The dude, her companion inside the arena. Like, his name is PETA.
Yeah.
And in the book he's this like monster. Like, yeah. Am I right?
Yeah,
he does not come across as a monster, right?
Oh no. He's not only not a monster. He is really not. Little. I mean. Yeah, well, not just that, but he is not good looking. That is not good looking man.
my god. So it's not just us, at least. Okay, so I don't feel that bad.
No.
One sec.
Well, they haven't even been here near as long as I have. They've only been casting for like 2 matches. Come on. Been here all day, guys. All day.
I'm about to alt chat, but I'm not. But I'm about to.
Yeah, from our perspective, this sucks. But I mean, for their perspective, like, this is such an important game for both teams because whichever team wins this, you know, gets to go compete in a league for $20,000. So.
I'm not. Don't worry. I'm not. I was just joking. I'm not that blatant.
Yeah, it's tough, man. I don't disagree. It is tough. I am dying here. Like, I have never been... My mic is messing up. I can hear an echo of myself. Oh, it's Holy. Holy, turn your mic off.
Yeah, I could hear your echo of myself, too. It was weird.
Yeah. Holy, you still on? There we go. Now it's gone. I've never been more excited to be done with some... All right.
The sad thing is I have been right here before, so this is, like, worrisome to me. Like, literally, I'm worried that I'm just incapable of sitting through an extended period of time of casting boring games. Like, that could be a real problem. You know? If a teacher hates kids, you know, that could be a problem. The caster can't cast boring games, you know, then...
Yeah, I think it's just boring, repeated boring games. I mean, that's so rare that it happens like that. Well, alright, see, the thing is, at least with our meta, like, I guess this must be what it's like to cast, like, Chinese Dota regularly. And, because don't get me wrong, I love Chinese Dota, actually. I love the purity of it. But, I can see, well, at least not, now Chinese Dota is very aggressive, so it's not a big deal. But maybe, like, Chinese Dota won, like, a year ago, which was just so farm-focused. And boring games than that, I'm sure, were quite boring. The good thing is, at least with casting, like, European meta, is that games that are one-sided are games that are one-sided because they're over in 20 minutes. Like, this isn't even one-sided. It's just, I don't know. Like,
It's close. The game's close.
Yeah, it is close. I mean, well, it's less close than I'd like to think it is because I really, I don't know.
Well, yeah. I see. What a big goal difference now.
Yeah, and just the Shadow Demon against Anti-Mage Factor. The Shadow Demon against Anti-Mage Factor is just so strong. But, I don't know.
Stop yawning. You're making me yawn.
I can't help it, man. It's so late
contagious.
Here.
Making all the viewers yawn.
It's so late. We've passed the 8 hours straight casting mark, so.
Yeah.
We're moving in on 9.
That's a lot. Oh man, we're moving up.
Yeah.
Europe's waking up.
Push. All right, action. Here we go. I'm focused. I'm ready for this.
All right.
I got this.
All right, watch out. So, watch out for the big ults on the American side, the Dire, pushing in. They have big ults. Watch out for those. We've got the Refresher also. Refresher ult ready to go on Tide. And likewise, watch out for the cancels of the cancel of the Enigma ult cancel. See if that happens. So we're going to see Enigma probably going here pretty late. All right, the push comes up. Damage comes out onto the tower. Sun as well. They're just going to poke, I think. I think they're fine with just poking this tower. Oh, we got a bolt. We got a one ult is out. Enigma comes out. Oh, there's no one to cancel. There's no one to cancel. This is very successful. Very nice to done. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that he didn't cancel that ult. He's just trying to get damage done. That's going to be GG, I think. Sexy. Two are already down now for the Brazilianos. Tower now goes down. Somebody bought back. Now it's one down apiece. Doo-doo. Oh, it's not me enough. Dude is going to get netted. Not netted, but whatever it is. I'm so done. Oh wait, well look at this. Melee Rax is now halfway dead. They're gonna go ahead and use Glyph, see if they can hold on a little bit longer. Still one apiece down. Now Lesh is coming back. It's not gonna be this fight though. The Melee Rax does finally go down. That is the second Melee Rax to go down. That is two lanes. This game will be over soon, whether you like it or not. You probably like it. And they can probably safely depart now.
I've got to say I'm a little disappointed that we will not be getting the Brazilian Anthem.
I feel like we should play it anyways, but whatever.
Yeah,
that just
well, we
doesn't make any sense at all. We can't get away with playing the Brazilian Anthem with an American win. That's like,
yeah, I think
get arrested for that.
Huh. Well, in Brazil.
In America.
No, in Brazil, man. Come on, they're very serious about their anthem only being used for serious sporting events, like victories over America. In this case, you would be using it for nothing. All right, well, we're going to go have a Roche steal here, and this Roche will go down quite quickly. So I guess there's still a possibility of some sort of nonsense here.
I don't know. We'll see. It's just, like, if you just saw the Shadow Demon... Oh, my God.
The Shadow Demon disruptioning... it's just, it's so tough. I'm running on fumes here.
Between the yawning and just the almost the inaudibleness of your voice just right now is like, I can't even do it. It's just so.
Alright, well, as I was gonna say, the problem is the Shadow Demon illusions of the Antimage just do so much damage. Like, in that spot, in that last fight, when the Rax was still up, but at, like, half health, the Shadow Demon just made the copies of the Anti-Mage, and he just set them on the Rax, and they single-handedly took the Rax down. And, like, the Anti-Mage actually had to start attacking the illusions to try to stop them, but it didn't matter, it was too late. And yeah, so I don't know, even with the Aegis here, I just don't think it's enough. I think they're just going to lose the fight anyway, because of the Anti-Mage illusions, regardless of whether they kill the Anti-Mage or not.
Yeah, no, there's no way that they're going to be able to win with an Aegis, even. He's too successfully countered, as you pointed out. And this is probably, obviously, a good reason why Anti-Mage has faded from the metagame for reasons having to do with what we're seeing right now. Shadow Demon in the metagame. AM, not so much. And if you are going to play AM, it's probably not a bad idea to last pick him, which they didn't do. He can still be just as, honestly, just as strong as he used to be. But you just pick him when he is, and you pick him late.
Yep.
That's my spiel. Come on, you guys end the game? I'm seriously gonna message. Okay, carry on.
No, don't do it. But anyway.
No, him personally. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, go.
Also, it's very strange that you would pick the Anti-Mage who gets countered by Shadow Demon via the disruption. And then you would pick the Sven, who actually gets countered by the Shadow Demon. You pick the carry Sven, you know, BKB, whatever, who gets countered by Shadow Demon because of the fact that his purge actually goes through BKB. Although I'm not 100%, does it still remove the Sven ult? Because I actually haven't seen that happen yet. The Sven has pretty much always held off on his ult until after he gets purged, but...
I'm going to go ahead and say that you can't purge it.
Because
I remember that everybody, I remember that he got buffed.
Yeah.
I think it was one of them.
It makes sense. All right, but even if you cannot, or if you cannot remove his ult, still when you purge him in when he's BKB and ulted up,
he's still useless, right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. He can't hit anything, so.
Although the question is, does that work still? Like, did they remove the ability to purge, to slow targets that are BKB'd? Why do I feel like that was changed? I don't know. Was it changed? I don't know.
Either way,
here we go. They're gonna go ahead and go on. Interesting. They choose two completely different targets to go on. It's not gonna matter. This is nasty. Now Pride is up, but he's doing decent damage. But now he's sheep. He's gonna go down very quickly here. They churn on him. He goes down. AM does not do anything. What the hell? How does he not hurt?
Oh, wow. I'll tell you what's gonna hurt. Those illusions they're about to make of him. Those hurt.
He just doesn't hurt. This is just... Well, here, now this is where the game turns around. Oh, wow. A little bit of a misstep here, but alright, there's the last tower in the lane, and the last Rax in the game. This all she wrote, America. F yeah. He goes ahead and moves on. What? Holy. Are you gonna do the American one?
Okay, well, to everyone who bared with us for this long, thanks for coming and watching. It's been fun. Sorry that we haven't been very focused at the end here, but yeah.
No. That'll be the last thing we do.
Yeah,
the last
you put it at the end. Yeah, we're gonna finish saying the goodbyes and everything.
Right,
okay.
Okay. You know, you already did it. You continue. Continue. Okay. Go! End it!
Regardless.
Please!
Well played by both teams. Good job, Brazil, for sticking in this long. It looked like you might have had a chance to take it out, but unfortunately the U.S. is too strong. Regardless, well played by both teams, and it's been fun. Thanks again to the Prodota tournament for hosting us and letting us cast this. Thank you, Gino, yeah, especially for coming and helping me cast before Chappie got here. Chappie, anything else?
No, that's it, man. Thanks for sticking through. Shout out to YouTube.